Hello children and my dear teachers. Now I am going to discuss about the cell, the basic unit of life. In our day-to-day life, we are observing different kinds of plants and animals around us. If you take the smaller ones to the huge plants, and also if we take the smallest animal to the biggest animal, all the animals and plants have the a basic unit of it, that is called cell. Do all the living organisms have the cells in it? Is it so? I will show you with the help of a video. In this video, you are observing a bird, a living organism. Every living organism made up of different kinds of organ systems, like nervous, digestive, circular, excretory system, and all different organ systems builds the living organism. In this video, I will show you the circulatory system. See, this circulatory system is made up of heart and blood vessels. This is the one kind of organ system. In this organ system, it is made up of different organs. I am taking the organ heart. In this organ heart, there are different other parts. This heart is made up of tissue. Tissue means a similar kind of cells which are structurally and functionally same. A group of cells which are similar in structure and function is called tissue. Here the tissue is made up of cells. See, you are observing the cell here. All the group of cells makes the tissue. Different kinds of tissue makes an organ. Different organs builds the organ system. Different organ systems builds the living organism. Like the same way which we have seen in the bird, all living organisms also made up of the cell. Like mosses, smallest plant mosses and wolfia to the huge plant Sequoia sempervirens in the world, and also the largest animal blue whale on the land, on the water. And if you take the land, African elephant is the largest animal. The largest living animal on the earth planet is blue whale. These are all have the cells in it, which we are observing here. Before microscope invention, nobody knows about these cells and invisible living world. 350 years ago, the microscope invention was done. After that, scientists are being exploring invisible world. And who worked in this field of invisible world I will show them. He is the Robert Hooke. He is the scientist who first discovered the cell in the cork of oak tree in 1665. And he is Leeuwenhoek. He is the scientist who observed the first living being, the microbe, that is bacteria, in the year of 1674. He named it as animalcule. Later it is named as bacteria. And he also observed so many microorganisms in a drop of water. And also he observed the red blood cells, sperms of different animals, paramecium, yeast. Different kinds of living microbes are observed by Leeuwenhoek with the help of the microscope developed by him. And you are observing the Athanasius Kircher. He also worked in the field of microbiology and invisible world. And he is John Swammerdam. He is also worked in the field of invisible world. I told you that Robert Hooke first observed the cells in the cork of oak tree. And how he found the cells and where Robert Hooke found these cells, I want to show you. How the cells looked like to him, I want to show you with the help of one video. Is Robert Hooke, He found the cells in the cork of oak tree. That cells looks like the honeycomb like structures. He named that structures as little rooms. Later they called as cells. How these cells appear, I will show you. In the microscope used by him also we can see in this video. Yeah, this is the microscope used by Robert Hooke. The cells observed by him, they are like a honeycomb. And he is Leeuwenhoek. He observed the cells like red blood cells, yeast cells, a different sperms of different animals, bacteria, paramecium. In the microscope of Leeuwenhoek, with the help of this microscope, he observed different kinds of living organisms in present in water and also around him. Robert Hooke observed a different Robert Hooke observed the first cells, I told, in the year 1665. Yeah, he found the cells in the cork of oak tree. Do we observe the cells which is observed by Robert Hooke? Means we can't, it is difficult to do that because we can't able to fetch the bark of oak tree. So we can do the similar, we can observe the similar type of cells which is observed by Robert Hooke at that time with the help of this activity. I will show you that activity. In this lab activity, the materials we required are matchsticks, the soaked matchsticks. I soaked them for 4 to 5 hours. Water in a watch glass, beaker, brush, blade, cover slip, slide, white paper, microscope. This experiment is done by my students in my school. To observe the cells which is observed by Robert Hooke, we have to do first, we peel the layer of the matchstick cell. We have to very careful while taking the peel from the matchstick cell. The peel should be very thin. We have to wash it in the water and later we have to keep it on the slide. Place the cover slip on it. Now remove the excess water from the slide and observe it under microscope. Now you will see the little rooms, small boxes like structures in this video. If you observe here, you can see. Yeah, these are the cells of the matchstick cells. These are dead cells. If we want to observe the living cells, what we have to do? If I'm talking about living cells, means in the cells present in plants and animals. If we want to see the cells in the plant cells, I'm taking onion to observe the plant cell. What we have to do for that? We have to do the lab activity to observe the cells of the onion. For this, the materials required are, this experiment is also done by my students, dropper, brush, forceps, needle, beaker with water, watch glass, onion, स्लाइड कवर स्लिप ब्लेड माइक्रोस्कोप. व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू टेक द पील फ्रॉम द ऑनियन. Take the peel with the help of forceps. Yeah, see, you have to take the very thin layer from the onion. Place it on the slide or directly. Oh, you can wash that layer in the water. Washing it with the help of brush. Make sure it is clear and place the cover slip on it. Removing the excess water from the slide with the help of paper or blotting paper and observe it under microscope. Adjust the microscope to observe the cells. See the brick-like structures with the thick walls. You are observing the walls of the cells also. The brick-like structures you are observing are all the cells of the onion. See, it is very clear here in this picture. These are the cells of onion. Keep in mind the structure of the onion peel cells. These are the cells present in the plants. Now I want to show you. The cells present in cheek cells. In this video, we will observe the cheek cells. For that, what are the materials required, we will see. Methylene blue, watch glass, toothpicks, cover slip, slide, white paper and microscope. First, what we have to do, we have to scratch the inner lining of our cheek. This experiment is performed by my students in the school. We have to be very careful while scratching or taking the inner lining cells. Add one drop of methylene blue to the cells. Place the cover slip on it. Remove the excess water present in it. Observe the cells. These are the cheek cells which you are observing now. The outer lining is very thin when compared to the plant cells, the onion cells. Okay. Now we have seen the plant cells and animal cells. Plant cells in onion peel cells and the animal cells in cheek cells. Now observe the questions. Write the procedure to observe the cheek cells of human. Who discovered the cell first? What are the main differences you observed in onion cells and cheek cells? Who observed the animalcules first? Thank you, everyone. I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye.